Dry cereals is a very big aisle, but as we're going to see, not many pass, and it's because of the added ingredients. And again, randomly, I'll just pick an item off the shelf, and you know, here's a kid's cereal, and gluten-free, organic, and when low-fat and low-sodium, 8 grams of whole grains. You know, all these things sound good, but you know, 8 grams isn't very much. A serving size is an ounce. An ounce is about 28 grams, so 8 out of 28 is not very impressive to me. And when we look at the label, you see that it's true, it's not high in fat. And we see, because it's less than 15%, it's less than 20%. We see it's not high in sodium, it's lower than the 1-to-1. But when we read the ingredients, we see the first ingredient is not whole grain cornmeal, it's just refined cornmeal. The second ingredient is whole grain cornmeal, which means the majority of the grains in here are not whole grain. And you know, to me, that just doesn't cut the mustard on my guidelines. And it's also got, you know, it's got some added oil. So, you know, we just don't need that in there. So let's find some that pass the guidelines. And when we step down here a little bit, here we'll find a few that actually will pass the guideline. And one of the ones that, besides Puff, that you can always count on are shredded wheats. Shredded wheats usually always make the guidelines. As we can see, ingredients 100% whole wheat. And let's go through the little formula. It's 140 calories, 10 calories from fat, that's less than 20%. The sodium is less than the calories, so that makes it. And there's no added sugars and no added salt. So you can find quite a few varieties of shredded wheat, but check carefully, because make sure we don't want added sugars or added salts. Another one that's been around a long time and is the original Kashi, and I'm mentioning this one because it is a great product. It's been around a long time, and as we can see, the only ingredients, again, it's a blend of whole grains. So we have whole wheat, whole brown rice, whole oats, whole barley, whole triticale, whole rye, whole buckwheat, and sesame seeds. So there's nothing else added. It makes, we could go through the label, 70 calories, calories from fat are 5, so that's less than 20%. The sodium, 0. And there's no added sugars. So again, another great product. Now, you know, I know the saying, you know, well, it tastes kind of plain, but the truth is we can add to this and spice it up ourselves. And the reason why I'd rather you do that is because we're more in control. We're in control. We can add a banana. We can add fresh berries. So we can flavor it up. We could add some cinnamon. And that's important, because when we leave it to some of the food manufacturers, we see that they get a little high in added salts and added sugars, and they switch the type of whole grains around and they use refined grains. So buy the simple product and flavor it up yourself with fresh fruits and spices. And if you want to add just a little bit of added sugar, then you can do it yourself at the table. And this puts you in control of what you're eating. And here's another brand that it's been around a while and makes all the guidelines. This is crispy brown rice, no salt added, 100% whole grain. But remember, when it comes to reading labels and my guidelines, there are two rules. And rule number one is, no matter what the company and what the product and what it says, rule number one says never ever believe anything on the front of any product. Always put it through my guidelines. So let's just do it to make sure. 110 calories, 20% is 22, so it clearly made it. The sodium is under the 1-to-1. We can see that. And let's read the ingredients. And the only ingredients are organic brown rice, and it has organic brown rice syrup. Now that's the second ingredient, but there's only two ingredients. So let's go down here and look at how much. And what we see is the total sugar is less than 1 gram. So we know this has less than 4 calories from sugar, and that's in regard to 110 calories. So since the total sugars are less than 5%, there's no way any added sugar can be more than 5%. So I would pass this product and say this is acceptable based on my guidelines. So as you can see, we found quite a few products that actually meet the guidelines. But the important thing we learned is to check. And even if you've seen me pick up a product and it passed, when you go shopping, it's a good thing to check. Because remember, manufacturers are always changing product formulations. So what's good today may not be good tomorrow. And over the last 25 years, I've seen that happen many times, where a product that used to be just 100% whole grain, you know, months or years later is now made from refined flour and has added salt or sugar. So always check, and that's one of the most important lessons.